I recently got in 9 TCG Player orders, Pokemon cards. These are cards that I needed to complete my Paradox Rift set. Wanted to open up each one and kind of do a little review and provide some feedback on how they did on their packaging. I am trying to normalize good packaging procedures on TCG Player. And that's the point of this video, just kind of let people know how I feel about it and why I think that it's important to package cards up for collectors out there like myself. I've got hundreds and hundreds of cards that I've sold. I maintain 100% feedback. The formula is very simple. It is a Pokemon card in a sleeve. Could be an ETB sleeve, could be a penny sleeve. That card is then going to go into some kind of plastic protection, a top loader or a card saver. Either one is fine. Usually if I'm doing one or two cards, top loader is my protection of choice. And if I've got more than two cards, card saver is my protection of choice. Put the card in the top loader. Make sure that it is at the bottom. Get yourself a team bag. I've got two different sizes. These are great for the card savers. These are great for the top loaders. Put it in there, fold it down. The card is not going anywhere. It is going to be perfectly protected throughout shipment. This is a 5 out of 5 method for shipping cards. Let's see how all these sellers did. I see this a lot where people will include an invoice and they'll wrap the card up in it. I'm fine with that. I don't know that it's absolutely necessary. So this first one, they're using, I don't like these. I am not a fan of these cardboard sleeves. They're called shipping shields. They're not easy to get open. We've got a cardinal sin right here of using scotch tape. Never a fan of that. Let's open it up and see how they did. I don't ever want to use knives. Like, I don't want knives anywhere near my cards. With the team bags, you just don't have to have that. All right, inside we've got a business card and we've got our card in an ETB sleeve. I would give that one a 3 out of 5. I don't like shipping shields. I don't like the extra paper waste. I mean, you've got to print that out. For my preferences, 3 out of 5. Another paper envelope. So once again, we do have an invoice with a card wrapped up in it. And we've got just cardboard. We've got a sandwich of cardboard here. Not secured at all. And, oh boy. we've got a card taped to the cardboard with like packing tape. Wow. So I'm just gonna take the card out of there. 1 out of 5. That's really not good. Another folded up invoice, and inside we find ourselves, what is going on here? We've got painter's tape. They've made us a little sandwich of plastic protection. So no top loader, no plastic protection. The card is trying to escape that sleeve there. I just don't have confidence that that's gonna stay safe during shipment. Card looks fine. It looks fine. I don't know, 2 out of 5. Another paper invoice, and inside we do have our first sighting of a team bag. It's a big one, and inside the team bag is cardboard. Folks, card savers, top loaders are not expensive. I don't understand. Like, I'll use cardboard if I'm going to ship a more expensive card, but I will put a top loader on the card, and then I'll put that inside cardboard. I don't know. All right, so this is 2 cards that they have stuffed. No, this is more than 2 cards. This is 3 cards that they have stuffed into the same penny sleeve. Not crazy about that. Not crazy about that at all. I don't remember ordering 2 beach courts. Probably did, though, because I make those accidents all the time. Wow, that's a good-looking special illustration. That's the first time that I'm seeing that one in person. Very pretty. Love that card. They would have been okay. Like, I'm fine with the cardboard, not the plastic protection, but sleeving 3 higher-tier cards into 1 penny sleeve? It's a penny sleeve. It's cheap. Give me a sleeve per card, please. Please. 3 out of 5 on that. I don't think I gave it a rating. Hey, we've got our first 5 out of 5, folks. Look at that. We've got team bag. We've got top loader. And we've got an ETB sleeve. That's it. That's all it takes. 5 out of 5. And there's no way that that is more expensive than using the cardboard and all the other shenanigans that we saw. Wasn't wrapped up in an invoice, nothing. So 5 out of 5, great job. Another one wrapped up in an invoice. We got no team bag. We've got our special illustration rare Goldengo. that is coming out of his ETB sleeve. You can see that there. I'm glad that it has not quite made it to the top, because otherwise it would be sticking to that painter's tape. I am somewhat okay with painter's tape. I think there's use cases for it. I don't like it coming anywhere near my cards, though. So using it to seal a top loader like that, not a huge fan of that. Appreciate the top loader. Appreciate the ETB sleeve. I would give that one a 3 out of 5. If you use any kind of tape at all, anywhere around my cards, you're probably going to, at best, get 3 out of 5. I'm just saying, but that's a cool looking card. I like that. Oh, side note, by the way, because I just realized it, this was shipped in a plain white envelope. Anything over $15 on TCG Player, they recommend that you send it via tracked, so like a USPS Ground Advantage kind of situation. Somebody just sent this to me in a plain white envelope. I could say, hey, I never received this card. Where's it at? Show me the tracking. You can't show me the tracking? I would get my money back and I would be able to receive the card. I'm not a scumbag, so I'm not going to do that, but there are scumbags out there. So I definitely, anytime I sell a card valued at $15 or more on TCG Player, I'm gonna pay for the shipping. And usually what I wind up doing is I wind up going over to eBay and selling them on there, because I can ship a card up to $19.99 using standard envelope shipping for 63 cents. Don't have to go up to Ground Advantage, which would cost you anywhere from $4 to $5. But yeah, if you're going to send more valuable cards, make sure that you package them appropriately and put them into something that is going to have tracking. Last three we've got here, and these are packages that were sent via USPS Ground Advantage. So usually what you see here are like larger lots of cards, which I think is what we've got first up. So we've got a team bag, we've got a business card, and we've got just a whole bunch of cards smashed into the same thing. So I bought all these from the same seller. They did a great job with most of the pack. Like, actually, I'm totally fine with this. It's something that I've actually recently started doing, and that I've noticed that other sellers were doing. I was like, oh, well, that makes sense if you use a team bag. So what they do is the sandwich method. They've got a top loader on the front. They've got two cards in the middle that are just, they're still protected. They've got sleeves on them, and then a top loader on the back. So it kind of creates that sandwich method where all of those cards in there, even though they're not inside the top loader, they are protected. And because they're in a team bag, they're not going to go anywhere. They're not going to escape, and they are going to stay within that plastic protection throughout shipment. 5 out of 5. I like it. I like it a lot. Next one up here, USPS Ground Advantage. We've got a ridiculously long thing of cardboard, and we've got scotch tape on all four sides. So I've got to look for a side where the cards are not. That way I can start to do some surgery. There's one there. See, like right here, you can kind of tell, like, the card is right there. And I really would rather not cut my card, but I mean, there's no other way to get into this other than cut that scotch tape. So just got to be very careful. I don't like how that has a lot of resistance. It makes me feel like I'm cutting through my card. There we go. All right, so I got two of the pieces of tape cut, and inside, that is not the card that I wanted to see inside of that situation. This was my chase card. This was the one that I wanted basically more than any other card, not because of the value, just because I love the artwork. I love using this dude in the TCG, the trading card game. He's a beast. That frenzied gouging is quite the maneuver. Packaging, 3 out of 5. Like, I'm tempted on 2 out of 5, because it's like, I mean, you could see it was already coming out of that plastic packaging, but I guess at least the cardboard was more than long enough, more than sufficient, and they did a good thing by getting Ground Advantage shipping, so it was going to be in a bubble mailer. Okie dokie then, last one, Ground Advantage. We've got... What? Is this from my mother? They sent me a candy bar. It says, thought I'd send you D's nuts also. We've got this thing. I've got a 7-year-old son. And he was like pretty obsessed with the D's nuts candy bars. Got a thank you card. Thank you for accepting D's nuts and Gengar, of course, from Captain Beefy. 2 builder buds. Oh, this is from my buddy Josh. Okay, all right. Yeah, look at that. We got the Gengar, the Haunter, and the Ghastly. We got the triple evolution line. That's awesome. Well, thank you, sir. D's nuts. I love it. Very, very cool. He gets a 5 out of 5 for that. 5 out of 5 on the packaging. Thank you, Josh. Thank you to all of you for watching this video. If you have any questions about appropriately shipping cards or platforms or anything like that, feel free to leave a comment down below. I do reply to every message because I just don't get that many. Small YouTube channel, and just interested in kind of growing the hobby and helping you out with your selling goals. So hit me up anytime. Appreciate you watching again. Ta-ta for now.